Hello and welcome to History Pod. On the 28th of January 1986, NASA Space Shuttle orbiter Challenger broke apart 73 seconds after it lifted off from the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The Challenger mission had three key objectives. Firstly, it was to deploy a satellite that was part of a system to enable NASA and other US government agencies to communicate. Secondly, it was to deploy the Spartan 203 satellite to observe Halley's Comet. Finally, on board Challenger was the first teacher from the Teacher in Space project. This program had been implemented by President Ronald Reagan and would see teachers delivering lessons from orbit. The night before the launch, the temperature had dropped below freezing. Ice had formed on the launch tower and on the shuttle itself. This led Rockwell, the contractor that built the shuttle, to express concerns. Furthermore, the company that provided the O-rings that sealed joints on the solid rocket boosters used at launch only had enough test data to guarantee them working properly down to temperatures of 53 degrees Fahrenheit, that's 12 degrees centigrade. On the morning of the launch, temperatures were 29 degrees Fahrenheit, or minus 1.7 centigrade, which was way below the tested safe temperature for the component. At 11:39 a.m., Challenger lifted off, and 73 seconds later, the shuttle began to disintegrate following a huge fireball. All seven members of the crew were killed, and the disaster led to NASA suspending all space shuttle missions for over 2.5 years. The crew compartment was finally found 370 meters beneath the ocean surface after 6 weeks of searching. The compartment had been severely damaged by the force of the impact as it entered the water. An investigation determined that the disaster happened due to two of the O-rings failing as a result of the low temperatures during the launch.